came to medical school, I knew I wanted a clinical research project, one that I could see the effects of somewhat immediately, of course, relatively speaking. So when I met with Dr. Apel and I saw he was answering this question that patients really want to know the answer to, I immediately wanted to climb on board.
It's unknown after different types of surgery, whether it be on the wrist or the shoulder or the knee, when a patient's safe to go back to driving. And these are everyday common questions from patients. Ariel's study was intended to answer a question of when can I go back to driving after having my carpal tunnel release surgery.
We didn't know if we could really even measure driving fitness. And so when we began this, it was really kind of a, let's see what happens, let's see if it's possible. We came up to VTTI, we looked at their instrumented vehicles. They collect all sorts of information from different camera views to all the kinematic metrics, yaw, acceleration, speed. It'll have GPS coordinates, it looks at even steering wheel angle. After we found that we could effectively and objectively measure driving fitness, it was great to be able to take kind of this proof of concept that was done on just healthy volunteers into an actual patient population. In the enclave, that's where we take the data collected from the hard drives in the car, which include, again, all the kinematic metrics as well as the camera views. And what we got to do was go through each video and determine the timestamps at which certain maneuvers were occurring. So I would kind of go frame by frame, write down the start point and end point of those maneuvers so that we could ultimately extract the kinematic data.
We wanted to do this in bigger surgeries.
This project started out asking simply a question about carpal tunnel release. And with our methods and the skills that we gained, we were able to answer the same question about rotator cuff release.
So what we found out, surprisingly, was that patients can drive pretty soon after surgery.
She found in her research that the traditional way of looking at this problem by simply measuring patients in a simulator doesn't capture who they are with their adaptive abilities. And in that way, she's changed the way that we think about this problem.
I think the research curriculum is very important. It's a wonderful feeling to be able to really answer the question patients want to know the answer to. I feel like that's something that has been said quite often for this project. It has far exceeded my expectations. So it's truly been such an enjoyable experience, and I'm really glad to have been a part of it.